halfway there, but not half-hearted. Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 best songs of the year so far.
Pressures of a new place roll my way. Time to
Before we begin, we publish new content every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos.
For this list, we're looking at the songs that have defined 2018's opening 6 months.
I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a song on a song on a song.
Yeah. Number 10, Make Me Feel, Janelle Monae.
Baby, don't make me spell it out for ya.
In a post-Prince world, pop music needs someone willing and able to push funk back into the spotlight. Working with the legendary musician prior to his untimely passing, Janelle Monae's enigmatic delivery elevates Make Me Feel beyond being a mere homage.
There's nothing better, that's just the way you make me feel.
Hardly lacking for energy, and bolstered by a scintillating synth line that echoes the sensual lyrics, Monae's single should be able to elicit a smile out of the grumpiest of faces. Tackling themes dealing with bisexuality, Make Me Feel's music video also deserves a mention for its fantastic choreography. Number 9, I Like It, Cardi B, Bad Bunny, and J Balvin.
Now I like dollars, I like diamonds, I like stunning, I like shining.
If asked to pick 2017's breakthrough artist, there would only be one right answer. Starting the year by landing a feature on Bruno Mars' successful Finesse, Cardi B instantly dashed any suggestions that Bodak Yellow was just a flash in the pan.
Yeah, they call me Cardi B, I run this shit like cardio.
Released as the fourth single from the rapper's debut album, I Like It is a Latin trap song that makes perfect use of its Pete Rodriguez sample and seems destined to dominate the summer club scene. Topping the Billboard Hot 100, Cardi B made history by becoming the first female rapper to score 2 number one hits.
Oh, he's so handsome, what's his name?
Number 8, Humility, Gorillaz featuring George Benson.
Calling the world from isolation. Cause right now that's the ball where we be trained.
While rarely described as cheerful, the legendary virtual band's music tends to shine whenever the gloom is replaced with a dash of optimism. A quick follow-up to 2017's comeback album, Gorillaz' Humility is not only a lot more laid back than anything on Humans, but shows a renewed focus on Damon Albarn's vocals. Benefiting from a fabulous guest feature by jazz guitarist George Benson, Humility might lack a memorable hook, but nobody can resist Albarn's vocals over a sprightly tune. If the music video is anything to go by, Jack Black seems to agree. Number 7, Hunger, Florence and the Machine.
At 17, I started to starve myself. I thought that love was a kind of emptiness.
Home to one of the greatest voices in the business, when Florence Welch sings, we listen. A natural progression from the indie rock band's 2015 album, Hunger serves as the perfect calling card for Florence and the Machine. Starting off with a rather subdued beat that instantly highlights Florence's life-altering vocals, Hunger's lavish instrumental bides its time before exploding into a rapturous orchestral chorus that complements the singer's soulful delivery. Technically, Hunger could be described as a love song, although the lyrics deal with the resulting emptiness from failing to reciprocate the emotion.
How could anything bad ever happen to you? You make a fool of death with your beauty, and for a moment I forget to worry.
Number 6, Psycho, Post Malone featuring Ty Dolla $ign.
Damn, I ain't been going psycho. La mama bad like Michael. Can't really trust nobody with all this jewelry on you.
This rock star is here to stay. After hitting the ground running with 2015's debut single White Iverson and reaching the top of the charts with Rockstar, Post Malone has cornered the market for mellow rap music over a catchy trap beat.
And I'm like, whoa, man, my neck so goddamn cold.
struggles of fame and the inability to trust anyone, Psycho knows better than to reinvent the wheel. Nevertheless, the accessible song showcases a confident artist who is fully in control of their sound. While detractors are unlikely to be impressed, Psycho is a quintessential Post Malone track.
Got diamonds by the bolo, don't act like you my friend when I'm rolling through my hands.
Oh. One kiss is all it takes, falling in love with me. Possibilities, I look like all you need.
Number 5, One Kiss, Calvin Harris and Dua Lipa. Part of being a producer is pinpointing which singer can elevate a beat to another dimension. When it comes to Calvin Harris, the Scottish DJ rarely misses the mark. Jumping on the Dua Lipa hype train, One Kiss trades the young English singer's dreamy pop for some good old-fashioned house music, but the starlet proves to be more than flexible enough to handle the shift in direction.
I just wanna feel your skin on mine. Feel your eyes do the exploring.
While the beat sticks close to Harris's signature moody but energetic style, Lipa's magnetic vocals are One Kiss's real highlight.
One kiss is all it takes, falling in love with me. Possibilities, I look like all you need.
Number 4, No Tears Left to Cry, Ariana Grande.
Right now I'm in a state of mind. I wanna be in like all the time.
Pop music always benefits from a dose of positivity. However, after the Manchester Arena bombing, the former Disney superstar would have been forgiven for not going in the opposite direction. Introduced with a melancholy beat that implies a ballad is on the way, No Tears Left to Cry subverts expectations by transitioning into a full-blown dance anthem that screams strength and resilience. Ariana Grande's soaring vocals continue to put to shame most of the singer's peers, while the triumphant hook manages to be simultaneously familiar and unique. Number 3, God's Plan, Drake.
I've been moving calm, don't start no trouble with me. Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me.
Over the span of 3 minutes, the Canadian musician flirts with trap, pop, and rap elements while handing out wads of cash to random strangers. After 5 commercially lucrative albums, Drake has condensed the art of hitmaking into its most fundamental state.
God's plan, God's plan. I hold back, sometimes I won't.
Debuting at number 1 on the charts and refusing to leave, God's Plan is less of a song and more of a victory lap. Whether referring to Drake's melodic singing, the bouncy beat, or the self-congratulatory lyrics, God's Plan incorporates everything that pushed the artist to the forefront of popular music.
Might go down as G-O-D, yeah, wait. I go hard on Southside G, hey, wait. I make sure that Northside E, yeah.
Number 2, All the Stars, Kendrick Lamar and SZA. Black Panther's soundtrack could have done much worse than these two superstars. Contributing an entire album worth of tracks, Kendrick Lamar's hot streak extended into 2018 with, arguably, the rapper's most commercial release to date.
Confrontation ain't nothing new to me. You could bring a bullet, bring a sword, bring a morgue, but you can't bring the truth to me.
Slightly short of innovation when contrasted to Lamar's usual output, SZA's towering vocals instill enough personality during the anthemic chorus to promote All the Stars into an unmissable track. Commenting on the importance of standing tall when facing adversity, Lamar follows through the verses like a seasoned pro who happens to be the best rapper in the game.
A smart percentage you I'm building with. I want the credit if I'm losing or I'm winning. Oh my mama, that's the realest shit.
Before we unveil our top pick, here are a few honorable mentions.
Haven't I made it clear? Want me to spell it out for you? F-R-I-N-D-S.
Number 1, This Is America, Childish Gambino.
We just wanna party, yeah, 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 yeah.
Describing this chart-topping masterpiece as merely a pop song would be a gross understatement. Fusing elements of trap, Afrobeat, and gospel, Donald Glover returned to the music scene with Childish Gambino's most ambitious track to date.
This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now.
Paired with the provocative music video that pulls silly viral dances against graphic depictions of violence, This Is America tackles racial stereotypes while examining the entertainment industry's influence on the public.
100 bands, 100 bands, 100 bands. Contraband, contraband, contraband. I got the plug on a hawker.
Whoa.
They're gonna find you like Baka Blah.
Referencing everything from Jim Crow to the Charleston church shooting, Gambino's This Is America is 2018 in a nutshell. Do you agree with our picks? Check out these other great clips from WatchMojo, and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.